I really appreciate you joining me today, and thank you to all our Spanish subscribers that have sent me the stories over the past few months. I've been doing regular videos on news from Spain due to the great interest, the close proximity, and also the large amounts of drugs that come through Spain to England. And we've had a lot of cases of British people being arrested in relation to importations from Spain to England. And in today's episode, the Spanish police have actually released the arrest footage of Jerry Hutch. And the official police statement says that he happened on August the 7th and he was arrested in the province of Malaga. And they say he's an Irish citizen and he's known in the criminal underworld as the Monk. He's 58 years old and they say that the Irish government want to extradite him and he's accused of murder. They say the investigation began when the Garda and the Irish police joined forces to put surveillance on him and to extradite him from the country. They said they initially found him in the Canary Islands and then they lost track of him, and then months later in April he appeared back in Malaga. The investigation was focused on the Costa del Sol and steps were taken by agents to corroborate that the defendant was residing there, and then they started to put surveillance on his home in the local area. They watched him leaving his home and walking through the busy streets into the city centre, and they say he was very aware of his own safety, and then he entered a restaurant where he was detained by the civil guard agents. At the time, they say he was found carrying false documentation and he has now been taken into custody, and the Irish authorities are about to issue extradition proceedings. And the Spanish police also say that they believe he was part of the Kinahan clan and then he fell out with them in a dispute, which led on to a war that resulted in many deaths. So that is the latest update on the Jerry Hutch extradition situation. And in some other news, the Spanish police have been really busy and they say they've taken apart the framework of an international drug organisation. This was a collaboration between Spain and Swedish criminals. So Eurojust and Europol collaborated with the Spanish police to arrest over 70 people. They say this gang was responsible for drug trafficking into Europe and beyond. And the police investigation began in 2018. And this was a request by the Swedish authorities to the Spanish police to get involved. They say this gang has control of the Stockholm and Gothenburg areas of the country. And recently I covered a Swedish rapper that was actually convicted in relation to a kidnapping and a drug organization that went all the way to Spain. They say they've seen Swedish criminals coming to Spain to organise transportations back to their native country. And the police conducted a series of raids. And the first phase was to find the company that was hiding the drugs and moving the shipments. They say the company was based in Alicante and Malaga, and they transported the drugs from Spain to the Nordic country, hiding it among the legal shipments that the company carried out. In the second phase of the operation, the police arrested some of their most violent criminals in Madrid. And they found a total of 1,700 kilos of hashish, 500 kilos of marijuana, 55,000 units of opiate drugs that was a substitute for heroin, 5 kilos of cocaine, 23 kilos of amphetamine, 2 submachine guns, a rifle, 8 short weapons, a hand grenade, 400 cartridges, £500,000 in euros, 1.8 million in euros in bank accounts, and Bitcoin wallets as well. And they seized 30 vehicles and 3 boats, 15 watches, 30 pieces of art, and designer clothes. They described the gang as a drug trafficking mafia that originates from Montenegro. So this goes from Montenegro to Spain, all the way to Sweden, and then on from there. They say some of the cash payments were up to £250,000 being handed over to gangs to go back to the Canary Islands. And in another seizure as well, located in Costa Adige, where a third member of the organisation was arrested with 70 kilos. The Tenerife police say they found another 338 kilos when they raided a property afterwards, and in addition nearly €500,000 in cash. The final result of both of them raids combined was 408 kilograms, that's nearly half a ton of cocaine. They also found 12 encrypted phones, electronic safety devices, and machine banknote counters as well. And this is really interesting with the phones as well, because regular viewers will be aware of the amount of EncroChat cases that have been ongoing. And this is also Sky Network, and also Anom has been taken out of the game. So 3 of the biggest encrypted mobile phone networks have been taken out, but police are still seizing encrypted phones even as recently as this month. So I can assume that they must have found a different network that they believe is safer than EncroChat. And this goes to show that criminals will not stop trying to find different methods to communicate without the authorities intercepting. In some other news coming from Spain, in a joint operation earlier this month, the national police found 1,100 kilograms of cocaine, that's just over a ton, in a container in a warehouse in Valencia. The narcotic substance was hidden in a sophisticated concealment system in the ceiling and in the floor of a structure of the container itself. The shipment was coming from Ecuador and its final destination was Spain. The investigators realized that the criminal organization was going to receive the massive amount of drugs and they decided to intercept it before it arrived in the port. As a result of several investigations, the agents confirmed the container loaded with frozen food had the drugs hidden inside, and then it was transported by truck and unloaded and stored in a container area. So that is a massive seizure for the Spanish police that would eventually have potentially gone on to Sweden, the Netherlands and the UK. So really appreciate you joining me for this latest update coming from Spain. Please don't forget to join us on the website for regular updates, and the merchandise is available on the website as well. Please don't forget to check us out on social media at Scar City Studios, and I'll be back again very shortly with some more news. Peace.